Greetings, this is Paul the Poke from paulthepoke.com. Today's topic, Pentecost, Shavuot, Feast of Weeks, Part 2. Today's scripture reference is in the New Testament, Hebrews chapter 5, verses 12 through 14. For though by this time you ought to be teachers, you have need again for someone to teach you the elementary principles of the oracles of God, and you have come to need milk and not solid food. For everyone who partakes only in milk is not accustomed to the word of righteousness, for he is an infant. But solid food is for the mature, who because of practice have their senses trained to discern good and evil. Now the author of Hebrews is addressing believers, and God's word is being equated with milk. So grow up. You're going in the wrong direction. Stop acting like a baby. Babies drink milk. Author's being very direct here. Babies do not eat solid food. And at some point, as believers in Christ, there should be some maturity. And these believers should be ready to eat real solid food and should get off of the liquid diet. Moreover, they should be teaching others about Christ and about what the Bible says. Second scripture reference is Hebrews chapter 6, verses 1 through 4. Therefore, leaving the elementary teaching about the Christ, let us press on to maturity, not laying again a foundation of repentance from dead works and of faith toward God, of instruction about washing and laying on of hands, and the resurrection of the dead and eternal judgment. And this we will do if God permits. For in the case of those who have once been enlightened and have tasted of the heavenly gift and have been made partakers of the Holy Spirit. So according to the text, these are the fundamentals of Jesus. I mean, these are the basics. Repentance of dead works, faith toward God, instruction about washing and laying on of hands, the resurrection of the dead, and eternal judgment. I mean, these are the ABCs. These are the fundamentals of faith. And it's also a reminder, you know, at the time of the writing of the Hebrews, Jewish men had been coming to Jerusalem for over 1,500 years per God's instruction for Shavuot in Exodus 23, verses 14 through 17. And this is, you know, this has been going on since the time of Moses. And God gave instructions for Shavuot, or Feast of Weeks, or Pentecost, to Moses on Mount Sinai on this ordained holiday in Leviticus 23. And the thing is that the terms Shavuot, Pentecost, Feast of Weeks, they are all synonymous. They're the same thing. It's the same holiday. Shavuot is often associated with God giving the Torah the birth of Judaism. And so effectively, the Torah was given 50 days after the Exodus. Pentecost is often associated with God giving the Holy Spirit the birth of the church 50 days after Passover. So part of the celebration of the holiday includes eating and drinking milk products. So the author of Hebrews is equating milk with the holiday as a reminder. So, you know, with all the dairy products, the milk and so forth, it's also a reminder to the Jewish people, hey, this is the holiday I'm referring to. I'm referring to Pentecost. I'm referring to Shavuot, Feast of Weeks. So the symbols and the elements of it, dairy products, they equate that with this holiday. Today, the tradition continues of drinking milk and eating dairy products with Shavuot, Feast of Weeks, Pentecost, whatever you want to call it. In addition, the book of Ruth is read. And there is a reminder to us as well, as believers in Jesus Christ, we have the Holy Spirit of God within us. We are sealed with the Spirit. And the reference for that is 2 Corinthians 1, verses 21-22. Now he who establishes us with you in Christ and anointed us is God, who also sealed us and gave us the Spirit in our hearts as a pledge. So, you know, effectively, we're all called to spread the word, and as the author of Hebrews would say, time to grow up and get off the teat. If you're interested in these sorts of topics, please feel free to check out Paul the Poke. symbolism.com, keyword Shavuot, Pentecost, Feast of Weeks. Thanks for listening. Take care.